Hello, in the last video we discussed about the preparation of DCC as well the application. So in this video we are going to learn about the synthesis of amide by using DCC. So that we all know the molecule of amide, that is nothing but the C double bond O NH2 molecules, that we call the amides. Then for the formation of amides we need the reactant molecule carboxylic acid and amines. Yes, so the difference between amides and amines, that you all know, but by direct reaction between carboxylic acid and amines we will not get the product amides. So that we need a reagent like DCC. So here the DCC that helps to coupling between the carboxylic acid and amines. So initially the DCC that converts carboxylic acid into anhydrides, that anhydrides after reacting with amines that gives the final product amide. So here we can see in the reaction the acid after reacting with amines, so these we call the reactant molecule. So this DCC is a reagent, then we get the product amides, byproduct acid. And here the DCC that convert into the dicyclohexyl urea, because the DCC means or the reagent that helps to proceed the reaction with change in their chemical nature, that is the meaning here. So here we can see in the structure it doesn't have the NH and C double bond O DCC, but after completion of the reaction what the DCC convert into an dicyclohexyl urea. Then the uses of reagent as well the catalyst, that is they proceed the reaction within a short of times as compared to in the absence of reagent and catalyst, and also they increases the yield of that product. So that is the main use of reagent and catalyst. Then you can see in here the mechanism. So first DCC reagent that first convert the carboxylic acid molecule into an anhydrides. Yes, that anhydrides after reacting with amines that gives the amide. Yes, the acid first react with reagent to form the compound 1. So before converting the acid into anhydrides we'll get the intermediate product that we call the compound 1. Why we name here the compound 1? So that joining of carboxylic acid molecule with the DCC reagent that gives the complex molecule. So that complex molecule we named it is a compound 1. So this compound 1 that having the good leaving group, that after reacting with the second molecule of the carboxylic acid molecule, so that gives the anhydride. Yes, so that means DCC convert the 2 carboxylic acid molecule into an anhydride. Then that anhydride after reacting with amines that gives the desired compound amide. Yes, this is the explanation we are going to see in that mechanism here in this. Well, the acid, it may be a carboxylic, means it may be a methanoic acid, ethanoic acid, propanoic acid, whatever the carboxylic acid we can use. This acid after reacting with the DCC that gives the compound 1. So why we named here the compound 1 is because it is a complex molecule. Yes, then I represent here H plus, that means it's a acidic medium. So this H plus that came from the second molecule of carboxylic acid, that H plus means electrophile means here it is an electron deficient center. So this always search the electron rich center in a compound 1 molecule. So here if you consider the electron rich center, that is the nitrogen, this hydrogen that attack on nitrogen that convert N into N plus. Yes, you can see here in the structure. Then at this position the second molecule of carboxylate ion that attack on the carbon. Whenever The negative charge means on oxygen that attack on the carbonyl group of carbon. Then this the bond between oxygen and carbon that shift into an this DCC molecule. That means in a compound that already form the complex ion. So after attacking of the second molecule of carboxylate ion on a carbonyl group, the bond breaking between the carbon and oxygen takes place. That a sigma bond shift to the carbon of the DCC molecule. At the same time, the double bond that is present between carbon and nitrogen, that pi bond shift on a nitrogen. So the totally this DCC molecule convert into N-N-dicyclohexyl thiourea. Yes, and the byproduct means or the main product we got here the anhydrides. This anhydride after reacting with amines, so that gives the amide and the byproduct acid. How we know the anhydride molecule and the amines? So here it gets the coupling reaction. Coupling means to join one molecule into another, means to join both the molecule into one by eliminating one of the byproduct. How it takes place? The said unsaid pair of electron, or also we call the lone pair of electron, that attack on the carbon of carbonyl group. After attacking this lone pair of electron on carbon, the bond break between the oxygen and carbon takes place. So that convert R C double bond O O minus. Yes. Then this nitrogen that loses its lone pair of electron, but it takes that lone pair of electron from this hydrogen. Then this hydrogen that eliminate as a H plus. So that H plus combines with R C double bond O O minus, that convert into acid. Then this nitrogen, they gets the bonding between the R C double bond O, that converts into an amide. So this is the product that we get by the reaction between carboxylic acid molecule and what? The amines. So for this formation, the help of DCC is very important, because initially that convert the carboxylic acid into an anhydride, then that anhydride after reacting with the amines, it gives the product amides by the subproduct that we call the acid. So note here, the R in a anhydride molecule, that may be a hydrogen CH3 or C2H5 etc. But in amines, R dash it should be CH3 C2H5 or C3H7, like that. Yes. So I think this clears the mechanism, the synthesis of amides by using the DCC reagent. So thank you.